Charleston, South Carolina. As one of the most venerable old ladies of the Confederacy, Charleston, South Carolina, has much in common with its haunted sister city of Savannah, Georgia. And real ghost videos happen here all the time. Both these cities were pivotal in the Civil War, with Charleston perhaps the more significant of the two, at least to invading Union soldiers who saw her as the birthplace of the rebellion. The first shot of the great conflagration that became the Civil War was fired just outside the city at famous Fort Sumter, and it was a shot that has echoed through all the long years since. Charleston is filled with an almost storybook beauty. Classically styled homes reminiscent of the great plantations still peek from behind romantic tangles of jasmine and bougainvillea or stand proudly under the moss-hung shadows of the great old oaks. Its rich history as one of the great port cities of the young republic is readily explored in the oldest sections of this fabled southern town. Centuries of history have drifted past her, too, in the lazy waters of the nearby river which pirates used to ply their contraband trade all along the coast of the eastern United States. In the earliest days of American colonies, Charleston became a haven for many of Europe's persecuted and deprived, especially the French Huguenot who fled the religious persecution of the French Civil War and found a home in the lush and verdant acres of what would become Charleston. The Huguenot Church is one of the oldest houses of worship in America and can still be visited to this day. At the height of his power, in May 1718, Blackbeard blockaded Charleston, South Carolina for a week. Shortly afterwards, the Queen Anne's Revenge ran aground and was wrecked. Blackbeard sailed on to Bath, North Carolina, which was then the state capital. The governor, Charles Eden, with whom, it was rumored, Blackbeard was in league, granted him a pardon and even officiated at his wedding, to what was reputed to be his 14th bride. Some locals say his ghostly head still haunts the area. No event forged the character of this old city more than the Great Rebellion that was the American Civil War, and seemingly no event has supplied more ghosts to the streets and historic areas of Charleston than this dramatic and tragic event. Fort Sumter is among the most visited historical sites in the United States, and is among the most haunted sites anywhere. Guided tours are available, and occasionally after-hours tours are offered. Many visitors have reported encounters with the paranormal and unexplained while touring this fabled location. Ghosts of both Confederate and Union soldiers seem to be on eternal sentry, and completely unaware of each other's presence, as they walk the stones of this old bastion of war. The first shot of the Civil War was fired here, and it did not bode well for the Federal soldiers who were stationed there. In 1861, the Union troops were forced to surrender. In 1865, the fort was occupied by men of the famous 54th Massachusetts Colored Regiment who, under the command of B.V.T. Brigadier General Edward N. Halliwell, had the distinction of occupying many of the famous symbols of the rebellious South. Halliwell, in command of the city from his quarters at No. 8 Meeting Street, placed his colored infantry in such significant locations as Sumter, Moore's Island, and the infamous Battery Wagner, where the regiment received its trial by fire. Many visitors to some of the historic sites that still remain have reported seeing the strong and direct images of these brave colored soldiers to whom victory over the South meant so much more. Others who have visited the area where Battery Wagner once stood have reported hearing cries and explosions coming to their ears over the waves under which the old fort sank long ago. Many of the oldest and most famous buildings in the old city boast numerous hauntings from all eras of the city's past. Church Street, Chalmers Street, Queen Street, Old Meeting Street, in almost every area of the old town there are ghosts to be found. Paranormal experiences occur with such regularity that many Charleston residents are proud to call Charleston home. Charleston offers historic and haunted walking tours, cemetery tours, buggy and trolley tours. Some include tours of underground passages that crisscross the city, used by pirates to transport treasure long ago and later by sympathetic Southerners as passages on the Underground Railroad. This is a Charleston don't miss. Boat tours along the historic waterways also include numerous tales of ghostly paddlewheel steamers and the wafting strains of calliope music from long-silenced pipes. And there are any number of graveyards and cemeteries to add to the overall ghostly gallivanting that is a highlight of any visit to this famous town.